Very good afternoon, class. Today I will be teaching about the topic nursing management of ENT diseases. Okay, so in the previous classes, I have completed about the ENT disease conditions. Okay, so there are many disease conditions of ENT, that is of ear, nose, and throat disease conditions. So this is just a general nursing management. Okay. So these are some of the nursing diagnoses which are applicable for ENT disease conditions. So number one is acute pain or otalgia. That is, otalgia is pain in the ears. Okay, so acute pain related to disease condition as evidenced by facial grimace or numerical pain rating scale which is equal to 8 by 10. So if because some of the disease conditions patients will have ears pain in the ears, which is called as otalgia. So that is one of the important sign and symptom, and this nursing diagnosis is applicable for the sign and symptom. Next is impaired communication related to otalgia and hearing loss as evidenced by not speaking to another person or lack of IPR. So by not able to hear, okay, or not able to, you know, having pain in the ear, so they're not able to hear properly and their communication is decreased. So this is second diagnosis. Third is risk for infection related to post-surgical intervention, risk for injury related to altered mobility and vertigo, anxiety related to disease condition as evidenced by patients complain of being anxious and tensed, and last is knowledge deficit related to disease process and surgical intervention. So these are some of the six important nursing diagnoses. This is like a general nursing diagnosis for ENT disease. So let us see their nursing intervention. So first is the acute pain or otalgia related to disease condition as evidenced by facial grimace on numerical pain rating scale equal to 8 by 10. So some of the nursing interventions are as follows. So first, we have to monitor the vital signs of the patient. Okay, we'll monitor the BP of the patient, temperature, respiratory rate, pulse. Next, assess the level and location of pain. So how much the patient is having pain. Okay, what is the level? Is it mild or moderate or severe or very severe pain? And where is the location of pain? Whether in the ears, right ear or left ear, or in the throat, or in the nasal cavity. So it depends on the location of the pain. Next, administer analgesic agents like NSAIDs such as diclofenac sodium or injection Voveron. Okay, so that it will relieve the pain. Next, encourage to use local warm compression or heating pads to relieve the pain. So warm compressions also we can give so that the pain will be reduced. Advise not to instill anything in the ear. So when patient is having pain in the ears, then we tell them not to insert anything or not to put any drops in the ears, okay, until the doctor has been advised. Next, provide bed rest to the patient and provide diversional therapy. Diversional therapy can be like, watching TV or giving video games or reading a newspaper or reading a novel or some other activity, indoor activity. Yes, so these are some of the nursing interventions. Next nursing diagnosis is impaired communication related to otalgia and hearing loss as evidenced by lack of interpersonal relationship. So IPR. Okay. So nursing interventions are number one, reassurance should be provided to the patient. Okay, we have to reassure the patient that everything will be all right. There's no need to panic, no need to be anxious, no need to be tense. Educate the patient about the non-verbal communication such as gestures. Okay, so like I explained to you, okay, about the gestures. Okay, so there are so many non-verbal communications. Okay, by using the hand sign language, okay, then that also will help the patient to communicate. Explain about the hearing aids. What are the positive effects or positive outcome of hearing aids? Okay, then explain about the hearing guide dogs. These are some special therapies for deafness. Then provide rest and comfort to the patient and reduce the tension of the patient. Okay, we have to reduce the tension, reduce the anxiety of the patient. Next, risk for infection related to post-surgical intervention. So after having any surgery in the surgery performed in the ears or surgery performed in the throat or the nose, okay, so we have to reduce the infection. Okay, there can be chances for the infection. So first is educate about hand hygiene measures. The hand washing technique should be taught to the patient. Educate about the personal hygiene. So maintenance of the ears, maintenance of the nose and the throat, personal hygiene should be followed. Next, provide antibiotics as prescribed by the doctors. Provide anti-inflammatory agents. Sterile dressing should be performed daily. Okay, so the dressing should be performed daily and they should be in a sterile technique. It should not be in a unsterile. Next, educate to keep the ears dry whenever they are showering. Okay, they are taking bath or washing hair, swimming to prevent water into the middle ear. So we have to tell the patient to cover the ears if they have to go for swimming or they have to go for they have to shower themselves or washing their hair. Then advise not to instill anything into the ear, not to insert any foreign object. Then reduce environmental noise. So we have to provide a calm environment, quiet environment. Next, risk for injury related to altered mobility and vertigo. So we have to, because vertigo, okay, is it's like dizziness. Okay, so we have to monitor the vitals of the patient, provide a safe and calm environment. So that there will be no injury to the patient. Then administer medication as prescribed by the doctor. Administer IV fluids. Place the patient in a safe place while having vertigo to prevent any injury. So if the patient is having dizziness, then you have to make sure that the patient is placed in a safe area. Next, provide rest and comfort to the patient. Reduce the anxiety of the patient and diversional therapy should be provided. Next, anxiety related to disease condition as evidenced by patient's complaint of being anxious and tense. Okay, so obviously when patients are having signs and symptoms of ENT diseases, so they will be anxious and they will be tense. Okay, they will have some tension. So the nursing intervention are, we have to provide rest and comfort to the patient. Allow the patient to express her fears and expression. So whatever problems they are having, we have to, as a nurse, we have to explain to them that they can share their problem. Okay, then as a nurse, we have to be compassionate. We have to be patient. Okay, we should have a good listening ear so that we, the patient also will have that trust factor. Then answer all the doubts of the patient. Whatever questions the patient is asking, we have to answer it factually. Explain about the positive outcome of the surgical intervention. Okay, and provide diversional therapy. Next, knowledge deficit related to disease process and surgical intervention. Okay, so we have to educate them about the disease condition. Okay, what is otosclerosis? Or what is tympanic membrane perforation? Or what is tonsillitis? Okay, or what is epistaxis? So all these disease conditions you have to explain to the patient. Educate about the positive outcome of the treatment regimen. So whatever medications they are getting, like antibiotics, we have to explain what are antibiotics or what are analgesics. Okay. Then educate about the positive outcome of the surgery to be performed. So if any surgery is to be performed, like tympanoplasty, so we have to explain to them what is the outcome or what is the positive outcome. Okay. Next, educate about the preventive measures. What preventive measures they have to take, that also have to be taught so that it can prevent any infection. Educate about the personal hygiene and hand hygiene measures. Explain about the medication dosage, the frequency of administration, matlab medicines ka dose kitna hai, kitna lena hai din mein, how many times in a day should the patient should take medicines, what is the expected outcome of the medicines, and for how many days or for how many weeks we should take the medicine. Ye sara explain karna hai patient. Then encourage the patient to verbalize their fears and concerns and answer the questions factually to reduce anxiety, to reduce tension. Okay, so these are some of the nursing interventions of specific nursing diagnosis. Okay, so I hope this is clear. Thank you, class.